Hi people, it's me, Anya. My pronouns are she and her, and welcome back to my channel for a new recently released video. First book on this list is called How to Find What You're Not Looking For. This book is a middle-grade historical fiction story that follows a young 12-year-old girl whose life completely changes when her older sister elopes after the 1967 Loving versus Virginia decision, which, if you didn't know, is the legalization that made interracial marriage in the U.S. legal. This book is absolutely so amazing, and it's so well done, and I really, really enjoyed it. I had really high expectations for this book because this author wrote The Night Diary, which is one of my favorite middle-grade historical fiction books, and that book is so excellent. So this book was also really excellent because it absolutely met and exceeded my high expectations because it was absolutely so good. First of all, the characters were so well-developed and they're so distinct. The main character is such a wonderful, lovely, well-developed character, and I also really enjoyed how her disability was incorporated into the story. It really made her so much more distinct, and the story is so emotionally touching, and it's just so well done. The plot was so intriguing, the world-building was so well done, and the setting was so well researched, and I really, really enjoyed it. This story is set in second person, which personally I thought would be more jarring and more unexpected, but frankly, it made me so much more hooked into the story. And this book is literally so good, and there's nothing I would change about it. And like I said, it was so emotionally touching. So I rated it 5 stars, and I would highly, highly recommend it. The next book on this list is called Echo Quickthorn and the Great Beyond. This book is a middle-grade fantasy following a young girl who's always wanted adventure beyond her small, isolated kingdom, and she's always wanted to go beyond that, but she doesn't know that there's anything beyond her kingdom until opportunity leads her elsewhere. This book is literally so good, and I really, really enjoyed it, and I ended up rating it 4 stars, so I highly, highly recommend it. First of all, the world building was so inventive, and it was so whimsical, and it was so well done, and it really made for a wonderful, lovely story. The characters were so well developed, and they're so distinct, and I'm so excited to read the sequel, because I have no idea what will happen next. The plot and the story was so intriguing, and it was so thrilling, and this was such a fun, wonderful, lovely adventure, and it was so well done. This book is absolutely worth all the hype and so much more because it's absolutely so good, and honestly it deserves so much more hype and so much more recognition because it's absolutely so fantastic and it's so well done. Like, every single element was so well developed and so well written. So with that, I would highly, highly recommend this book because, like I said, I ended up rating it 4 stars because I really, really enjoyed it. The next book on this list is called A Dark and Starless Forest. For those who don't know, this book is a YA urban fantasy and follows a young plus-size sapphic queer girl who must confront the growing darkness within herself as well as the dark thing inside the forest when her siblings start to go missing. This book was solid and it was good. I ended up rating it 3 stars because I enjoyed it, but I didn't absolutely like fall in love with it or anything like that. I did enjoy the representation in this book, which is why everybody loves this book. I feel like everybody praises the representation in this story, and I understand that like people enjoy this book for more reasons other than the representation. However, for those other reasons, like the plot and the world building, the magic system and all of that, those are the elements that I didn't really fall in love with, which is why I personally did not rate this book any higher than 3.5 stars. But anyway, I liked the magic system, the plot was intriguing, it was kind of thrilling, at some points it was kind of predictable. As for the representation that is in the story, if you didn't know, the main character is plus size and queer and sapphic. Many of the other characters were queer and sapphic and people of color as well, so we love to see it. I believe that one of her siblings is also deaf, so there is some disabled representation, we love to see it. But anyway, as I was saying, aside from the representation, I didn't really fall in love with this story, and I don't really know if there's one specific reason why, or if it's just because I just don't love urban fantasies. But I do understand why everybody else loves this story, like, so much. I felt like the magic system could have been developed more, and, like, other things like that, basically. So, with that said, I don't know if this review makes any sense at all, But essentially, I didn't love this book as much as everybody else did. I ended up rating it 3 stars, but I do understand why everybody else loves it. So with that, I don't really recommend this book, but yeah, there's that. The next book on this list is called The Blonde Beasts. For those who don't know, this book is a YA historical fantasy, and it's the end of the Gilded Wolves trilogy, and honestly, this book is my least favorite out of the trilogy. I did really enjoy this book, and I did end up rating it 4 stars, because I enjoyed the return of my favorite characters, the atmospheric setting, the wonderful writing, the action-packed, fast-paced plot, the world-building, like, everything about this story, well, mostly everything about the story, was really, really good and really, really solid. However, there were 2 main reasons why I didn't love this book as much as the other 2 books in the trilogy, and the first reason is that I've never really cared about the romances in this trilogy, so when the romances were developing and were being established, I didn't really care. You know what I mean? So I wasn't really hooked by those elements specifically, and secondly, especially towards the end, I didn't really understand what was happening, which frankly doesn't always happen when I'm reading fantasy. I read fantasy so often because it's my favorite genre, and typically I do understand what's happening, I understand why it's happening, like everything makes sense. So basically in this one, I don't know what happened, but especially towards the end, it was a bit complicated to understand like why things were happening. Like, I can tell you what happened in the end of this book. I won't, because that's going to spoil the ending of this fascinating trilogy that everyone's looking forward to, but I can't tell you why it happened. And I don't know if that's a me thing or if it's the book thing. Like, I don't know like whose fault it is necessarily, but anyway, basically, those are the 2 biggest reasons why I didn't love this book as much as the first 2 books. So with that said, I would rate this book 4 stars, and ranking the books in this trilogy, my favorite one is The Silvered Serpents, and then The Gilded Wolves, and then this one. But overall, I would highly recommend this trilogy, because I will say that this trilogy is as good as everybody else says it is. Even though I rated each of the books in this trilogy 4 stars instead of 5 stars like everybody else does. But anyway, with that said, I would highly, highly recommend this book. The last book on this list, but certainly not the least, is called The Insiders. For those who don't know, this book is a middle grade magical realism story following a young Mexican gay boy who finds a magical closet within his school that brings him friendship and community. This book is literally so good, and I really, really enjoy it. I had really low expectations for this book because I've DNF'd this author's other YA books, and I believe that this book is his middle grade debut, so I wasn't really expecting this book to absolutely slap. This book is so good. It's so wholesome and it's so sweet. I really enjoyed the friendship between all of the characters, and all of the characters were so well developed, and they're all so distinct, and I really enjoyed how diverse the cast of characters were. This book is literally so good, and it's so underrated, and it deserves so much more hype, because it's absolutely so good. It's so wholesome and so sweet. It's so magical. It's just so good, and it's so happy, and it's so well done, and all of the elements were so well developed. The plot, the friendships, the characters, this book is literally so good, so I would highly, highly recommend it, because I ended up rating this book 4 stars. So, in conclusion, my favorite book on this list, by default, is How to Find What You're Not Looking For, because I rated that book 5 stars, and it's the only 5-star book on this list. And the lowest rating book on this list is definitely A Dark and Starless Forest, because that's the only one that I ended up rating 3 stars, because I rated all the books in between 4 stars. So in conclusion, I would recommend all the books on this list except for that one. So anyway, if you enjoy this video, please don't hesitate to give it a big thumbs up. Comment down below the pink heart emoji if you made it all the way to the end of the video. Thanks for watching, subscribe to my channel if you're new, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!